Hello, Alan Noon here, and today we're going to talk about camera shake. Now, camera shake is one of the most important and fun elements you can add to your game in order to create a sense of dynamism and excitement. So let's go ahead and do some of that now. You see I have the first person template open, so if I go ahead and play, I can fire my weapon, and that's all well and good, but we can make it a little more interesting. So let's go ahead and get started. If we right-click in the content browser and create a new blueprint class, if we do a search on shake, you see that camera shake comes up. So we'll pick that, and we'll call this my shake. I'm going to open that up, and down the side we have all of the different settings. So first thing we want to do is determine how long the shake should last. So we'll say quarter of a second. Now we have rotation oscillation. And we're going to add some pitch and some yaw. So I'll just plug in a couple of values here. 5 for the amplitude, 50 for the frequency. So we get a little bit of vibration. And then I'm also going to jump down to location. And let's start with Z. So that'll be vertical shake. And we'll go with 10 units, and we'll use 50 again. But now we're going to add some on X. So as you know, in Unreal, X is the forward axis. So we're going to go ahead and do 100 units, but we're only going to do this once. We're only going to oscillate once. And we're going to change this setting here to 0. So what this setting does here is, you see the others that we picked are random. So that means every time the camera shake fires, it's going to either start in the positive or negative direction on that axis randomly. But here for X, we're going to say that we're always going to start from 0, and we're always going to go in the positive direction since we've picked 100 units. Okay, so we'll compile and save that. And now we'll go to our first person character. And you see here, this is where we're actually firing our weapon. So I'm going to track all the way down to the end and drag off. And again, we'll search for shake. And you see here, we want Play World Camera Shake. Now from the drop-down, we can pick our shake, which we named My Shake. And the first thing we need is a location from which to play this shake. And it just so happens that in this graph, we have a node for Get Actor Location, so we can go ahead and borrow that. Now the radius specifies where the shake starts, the epicenter, if you will. And then also how far out from that location the shake will affect cameras that fall within it. So we're just primarily concerned with our own camera on the character, so we'll just give it a relatively small value. And fall off we'll just leave here. And that should be all we really need, so we'll just compile and save that. And now when we go back into our game, there you have it.